Eastim, you may know Eastim 10 years ago. Indonesia killed 100,000 Eastim at the massacre. That's because of John Peter getting bring the, some information out and people find out. And also British people involved in support and Australians, Americans, all around the world support because that message came out. But it was Papua. Indonesia killed 400,000 my people. But no one knows. This is why nobody knows what really happened, what really going on. And our pastor, we are known because discrimination, many kind of discrimination.
That's why we're campaigning for new referendum for West Papua. In terms of the support, yeah, there is some British Parliament, all party, cross party are supporting West Papua self-determination, campaigning for self-determination issue.
That by the gunpoint. That's why international lawyer for West Papua look at the legal case, legal issue. The politicians were mobilized, look at the political, because West Papua was a victim. Indonesia really played clever game. Okay, if the Dutch don't give West Papua, we will join Cold War. That's why Dutch, America, and you know, Europe, including British and Australia, decide, okay, that you have to give the West Papua to Indonesia. That's what the Indonesian trick they done. So that's why it's a, we are victim of the global interest, of the, our resources, our natural resources, economy, geopolitics. That's why we are campaigning. I think the internal campaign, very successful. I launched international lawyer, international parliamentarian for West Papua in British Parliament. Last 2008, and Caroline Lucas was international parliamentarian for West Papua in Brussels, European Parliament, and also in Papua New Guinea, South America, I think a lot of growing number. That's why Indonesia put this red notice to extradite me from the United Kingdom. That's what happened, but the growing support, that Indonesia getting worried because mobilized support is really, really getting there. Because they already lost Eastim and West Papua. People now mobilize themselves, come out, because Twitter, Facebook really help the voice come out. Even the journalists, there is no allowing West Papua. Amnesty ban, you know, restaurant ban. I think that's momentum gain.
Thank you very much for coming. I think it's really, it's so important for all of us here that important and inspiring that we hear from you about West Papua. So thank you. And I was going to ask a similar question, but can I also ask, does our government put any restrictions on your movement or political activities or anything like that?
Really up here. It's just something that, that's why I said I'm grateful to be here. And this is why I really thank for these people, this government, allow to use this freedom, because at the moment I'm able to travel freely in this country.
Thank you.
But I know the British intelligence always, you know, help me, you know. I know they run, so that's, I'm not, physically I'm safe, but mentally I'm, because I left my people with the hand of the Indonesian military, and they're truly tortured, that's why, but I'm safe, yeah, so.
To get a bit more of a picture of your country, I hope I didn't miss it, but how many people live in West Papua, and how many people are there living in exile from West Papua? And if you can tell us a bit more about the countries, that it's got hills and jungle, how much of the country is covered in jungle?
Yes, there's a number of, compare Papua New Guinea and West Papua, it's a 50-50 at the time. But Papua New Guinea now 7 million. West Papua, they already on 1.5 million. That number never changed. Why Papua New Guinea population is growing? Why was Papua still? Because number of people have been killed. Indonesia killed 400,000 of my people, already investigated by Amnesty International and Church investigate. And today, while I'm talking, last month, 19th of October, all West Papuan people come out and gathering, peacefully rally, and three people been killed on the spot, and 300 been arrested and tortured. The picture in front, we already put in there, just peacefully, ceremony peacefully come out. This is open fire, and there is all spread on YouTube and everywhere. This is because of the number of killings, or because the political reason I want to, my people must free like other people. That is it. But in terms of healthcare, it's nothing. Because we are still a colony, and they treated us a different way. Only in this capital, you can see this, some more development. If you go to the, in the villages, remote, there's no teacher, there's no, nurse, They just go back to the, city, because who want to help? That's what happened in the situation. That's why, women that, get burned and sometimes, die because hospital too far and get burned in the house. It's really sad. So, people outside work with free support to help my people. That is amazing. But in terms of the personnel, please put pressure to the government to allow journalists to fish in West Papua, because at the moment journalists are banned, totally banned. So that's why Indonesia get away the murder, killing, the prison in West Papua. And please tell your MP to put pressure on the foreign affairs, foreign minister to campaign more and let the journalists in. That's the main campaign. Maybe to help.
Nearer you than the UK, like Australia and China, maybe the Americans in Honolulu. What are the attitudes of the other countries, that Malaysia, that surround you or are nearer to you?
2008 polling opinions on Australian citizens, 75% support West Papua because the experience is Timu. The majority of support with the system independent. The people are saying, because same military are fight our country, so that's why they really support. Papua New Guinea, the people are really similar, same culture, same only border. The people are supporting, but the government they cannot support because Australia put pressure on Indonesia, threatening the government. I've been in Papua New Guinea 8 months ago, and all the politicians, new generation come out, no, this is our brother being killed in front of our eyes. We will stood up, and I launched the international parliamentary for West Papua in the Papua New Guinea Parliament. So it's increasing support, rest of the Malaysian.
I will travel anywhere until my people free and I will stop. As long as my people not free, I will travel. Tell the truth for the Thank you.